Thank you for your generosity. Thank you for your presence. And thank you for your wonderful music ministry. It is a joy to be here with you again. I did survive a week, but I'm still here. But it's been a wonderful week at Cedar Lane. I've really enjoyed meeting a number of you in various gatherings, at committee meetings, social gatherings like the Ice Cream Social, as well as in the three town hall meetings that we had. They were all very engaging, robust, even a little challenging. Because you asked me some thoughtful and probing questions about who I am, what I bring, my vision of ministry, and how it might fit with your own. And you also, in the process, shared with me your dreams and your hopes for the future of this, your spiritual community. I'm deeply moved and inspired to see your dedication and commitment to your spiritual community and excited by what we might accomplish together. It was especially a blessing to be present and witness to three important rites of passage of your children and youth. The Stepping Stones class, of course, yesterday evening, a very powerful and moving ceremony with the coming of age and what we experienced this morning as well. What a gift to be the recipient of all in 1 week. You did good. But it's also been a challenging and hard week for us as a nation. A terrible and wanton act of violence at a venerable sporting event, the Boston Marathon, a celebration of the human spirit that was destroyed in moments by a bomb explosion, too. An explosion that killed people and maimed and injured many others, and then was followed by that massive manhunt for the alleged perpetrators, which shut down the whole city and culminated in the death of one and the capture of the other. We also were witness to this powerful blast at a fertilizer plant in the town of West in Texas, which pretty much gutted this small town and killed 15 people, including many volunteer firefighters who responded to the scene. And of course, Rison-laced letters with threatening messages sent to the president and a Republican senator, and the defeat of a common sense gun control proposal that would have allowed us to do background checks to prevent convicted felons and the seriously mentally ill from purchasing guns online. Taken together, my friends, it has been a chaotic and nerve-wracking week. I'm reminded of Frederick Buechner's daunting words, "Here is the world beautiful, and terrible things will happen. Don't be afraid." Don't be afraid. Because especially in these troubled and troubling times, we need a faith such as ours, a religious community such as this, to reassure us to not be afraid, to remind us of the difference between that which is transient and enduring in life, a place where we learn to minister to one another and to work together to heal a broken, hurting world together. In 1824, a Bostonian, William Ellery Channing, preached a sermon at the ordination and installation of his junior colleague Ezra Stiles Gannett, titled "Demands of the Age on the Ministry." Now, Channing used as his text a verse from Matthew that set a somewhat ominous tone to the proceedings. "Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves." Doesn't relate to me, though. Now, those of you who are familiar with and have worked with the Barber Church Council's Sister Church program, I know you have a relationship with Unitarians in Transylvania. Unitarian Universalism has always believed that human love and goodness are stronger forces than human hate and destructiveness. Now, the love I'm referring to is not that syrupy, happy love of pop songs or the fleeting infatuations that we incorrectly label as love. The love that I talk about is a persistent love, a love, as Rob Hardy would say, that will not let us go, that will not let us down, that will not let us off. A love that refuses to give in to the cruelties of this world. Our universalist faith has shown us that God dwells in love, inhabits love, embodies love. That God is love, and that love is God. This radiant, ever-present love is the source of our hope in times like these. And this love binds us not because we believe the same things, or because we go to the same worship place, or even because we are citizens of the same nation. This love binds us because God, or the divine impulse, the ground of our being, is within each and every one of us. And in the end, it is our love for one another that shines most brightly. And the purveyors of hate and perpetrators of violence never succeed as long as this love abides. And ours is a pluralistic, multicultural age that demands a pluralistic, multicultural, diverse ministry. The novelist Salman Rushdie might not usually be considered a likely source for a quotation in support of diversity. He has fashioned a genre which he has termed theological comedy, which seems more frontal in its satires. But hear his statement of intent, however you may assess his work. He writes, "The satanic verses celebrates hybridity, intermingling, the transformation that comes of new and unexpected combination of human beings, cultures, ideas, politics, movies, songs. It rejoices in mongrelization and fears the absolutism of the pure. The hodgepodge, a bit of this and a bit of that, is how newness enters the world." And then he confesses, "Like many millions of people, I am a bastard child of history. People, we all are, black and white, while leaking into one another, like flavors when you cook. I say, let it continue." Unitarian Universalism celebrates